Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Dr. R. J. Varia. So today's online session is on DOAP, that is for competency number PA 23.1. The competency is describe abnormal urinary findings in disease states and identify and describe common urinary abnormality in a clinical patient. So this DOAP is very important for exam purpose as well as for your routine clinical knowledge purpose. Specific learning objective for today's DOAP: urine examination spectacles. So this urine examination spectacles include three sub types, that is physical examinations of urine, chemical examinations of urine, and microscopic examinations of urine. So according to specific learning objective, right, perform physical examinations of urine with their clinical importance, perform biochemical or chemical test in urine and their clinical importance, know various findings of microscopic examinations of urine with their importance. So for practicals, you should perform physical examinations, also you should perform some chemical test for given urine samples, and you also have knowledge about microscopic examinations of urine, various findings in microscopic examinations and their clinical importance. Coming to urine examinations, examinations of urine is important for diagnosis. So it itself diagnostic for certain conditions. Also it assists in the diagnosis of various diseases. Routine or complete urine examinations includes specimen collections, physical or gross examinations of urine, chemical examinations of urine, and microscopic examinations of urine. Coming to specimen collections, for routine examinations, preferable specimen is first morning samples, because these first morning samples have most concentrated. That's why various findings are easily get in first morning samples. For bacteriological examinations, midstream samples, that means initial portions of urinations is not included in samples, middle portion is included to prevent bacterial contaminations. So for bacteriological examinations, midstream is preferable samples. Sometimes 24 hour urine collections is required. So for 24 hour urine samples, collections of urine is started in the morning at 8 a.m. First voided sample is discarded and all subsequent samples are collected till the next day 8 a.m. That means 24 hour durations urine specimen is collected. Random samples good for screening. Disadvantages of random sample is it may get diluted, giving false pictures of patient's health. Then there are special types of samples like PG2US, that means 2 hours post glucose. This is specially done in case of glucose tolerance test. So after giving glucose, after 2 hours urine samples is collected, that is PG2US, done for diabetic patients. Then PP2US, right, for sugar estimations in serum, that is PP2BS, blood sugars, here urine sugars, US, PP2US. 2 hours post splendor, after meals or food. This is also done for diabetic patients. Sometimes early afternoon samples is required, especially for measurement of urobilinogens, because level of urobilinogens are highest between 2 to 4 p.m. Then method of collections, sometimes special methods required, right, catheterizations or suprapubic aspirations. Catheterizations may be required in following patients: patients with difficulty in voidings, female patients to avoid contaminations during menstruations, and unconscious patients. Suprapubic aspirations, that means needle is inserted in suprapubic portions into bladders and urine is collected. This is invasive procedure, but sometimes it required in case of infants and children. After collections of urine, coming to methods of preservation of urine. Urine should be examined fresh or within 1 hour. But if it has to be delayed, then following preservative can be used. So various methods for preservation if there is delay in examinations of urine, especially more than 1 hour. Refrigeration at 4 degree centigrade temperatures. Urine can be preserved up to 8 hours at 4 degree centigrade. Then various chemical substance can be used like toluenes, 1 milliliter per 15 milliliter of urine. It acts by forming a surface layer and it preserves the chemical constituents of urine. Formalin, 6 to 8 drops of 40% formalin per 100 milliliter of urine. It preserves RBC and pus cells. So for microscopic examinations, it helpful. However, disadvantages of formalin is it sometimes gives false positive test for sugar. Thymol, it is good preservative. 1% solutions of thymol is used. Disadvantages of thymol is false positive test for proteins. Various acids can be used like hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acids, folic acids as a preservatives. So these are various preservatives. Coming to physical examinations of urine, this includes volume of urine, color, appearance, odor, reactions of pH of urine and specific gravity measurements. Coming to volume of urine, normal volume is 700 milliliter to 2500 milliliter, average is 1200 milliliters in 24 hours in adults. Nocturia, excess urine passed during nights, especially when it is greater than 500 milliliters. Causes of nocturia, sign of early renal failures and diabetes mellitus. Polyuria, excess urinations, excretions of more than 2500 milliliters of urine in 24 hours. Causes for polyuria, physiological causes like excess water intake and seasonal, especially in winters. Various pathological conditions that leads to polyuria are diabetes mellitus, diabetes insipidus and early stage of chronic nephritis. Oliguria, less than 500 milliliters of urine in 24 hours. Causes of oliguria, less intake of water in summer, dehydrations due to excessive vomiting or diarrhea, acute and chronic glomerulonephritis, CCF, congestive cardiac failures, shock, renal ischemia and high grade fever from any cause. Then anuria, almost complete suppression of urine formations. So here urine is less than 100 milliliter in 24 hours. Causes of anuria, acute glomerulonephritis, terminal stage of chronic renal disease, crush injury, renal ischemia, tumors, renal stones, after a mismatch blood transfusions. After volume, coming to color of urines. Normal color of urine is pale yellow or straw colored. Pale yellow or straw colored. This pale yellow color normally is due to presence of various urinary pigments in minor amounts like urochromes, urobilinogens, uroerythrin and uroporphyrins. Significance of colors, red means change of colors from normal colors to various abnormal colors. Sometimes urine rather than pale yellow may be colorless whenever urine get diluted or whenever there is excessive polyuria. Urine may be colorless. Deep amber colors due to strong muscular exercise or high grade fevers. Orange colors increase urobilinogens. Concentrated urine due to dehydrations or shock. Smoky urines, small amount of blood or administrations of vitamin B12 or aniline dye. रेड कलर यूरिन हेमोसूरिया और हीमोग्लोबिन यूरिया, दैट मींस प्रेजेंस ऑफ ब्लड और हीमोग्लोबिन इन यूरिन। येलो टू ब्राउन कलर्स ड्यू टू बाइल, आइदर बाइल सॉल्ट्स और बाइल पिगमेंट्स। मिल्की यूरिन ड्यू टू पस और एक्सेसिव फैट विथ इन यूरिन। ग्रीन कलर्स दिस अकर्स ड्यू टू प्यूट्रीफाइड सैंपल्स और फिनॉल पॉइजनिंग। कमिंग टू ऑर्डर्स ऑफ यूरिन, नॉर्मली यूरिन हैज अ फेंट एरोमेटिक ऑर्डर्स, देयर इज एबनॉर्मलिटी इन ऑर्डर ऑफ यूरिन। पंजेंट ऑर्डर्स ड्यू टू एमोनिया इन लॉन्ग स्टैंडिंग यूरिन। प्यूट्रिड ऑर्डर्स ड्यू टू यूरिनरी ट्रैक इन्फेक्शंस। फ्रूटी ऑर्डर्स ड्यू टू कीटोएसिडोसिस एंड माउसी ऑर्डर्स ड्यू टू फिनाइल कीटोन्यूरिया। अपीयरेंस ऑफ यूरिन, नॉर्मली इट इज क्लियर। If there is cloudiness on keeping, it may be due to precipitations of phosphates. If there is cloudiness on cooling, it is due to precipitations of urate crystals, and urine may be turbid. There are various causes of turbidity of urine, right? Presence of phosphates, pus cells, bacteria, spermatozoa or fat droplets. Reactions of or pH measurement of urine, it can be measured using pH indicator papers, electronic pH meters or litmus papers. So nowadays routinely urinary strip is used, which includes pH indicators within the various parameters on the urinary strips. It can be measured by litmus papers whether it is alkaline or acidic, and specific instrument for pH measurement is electronic pH meters. So here three methods for pH measurement. One is urine strip, then litmus paper and electronic pH meters. Freshly voided normal morning samples of urine is slightly acidic and its pH ranges from 4.6 to 7, average is 6. So normally urine is slightly acidic. Excess acidic urines due to high protein intakes, like intake of meat, ingestions of acidic fruits, respiratory or metabolic acidosis, and urinary tract infections by E. coli organisms. Rather than normal acidic urines, if it is alkaline, various etiologies, citrus fruit intakes, respiratory or metabolic alkalosis, and urinary tract infections by Proteus or Pseudomonas organisms. Coming to specific gravity measurement of urine, specific gravity is used to measure the concentrating or diluting power of kidney. It shows diurnal variations being higher in the morning, as in the morning there is concentrated urine, so specific gravity is higher, and lower in afternoon, that means after meal, specific gravity is lower. So normal diurnal variations is present in specific gravity. Various methods to measure specific gravity of urine includes by using urinometers or using refractometers and reagent strips. Coming to specific gravity measurement by urinometers, simple instruments, urinometers. Method, fill urinometer containers 3/4 with urine. This one is urinometer containers. So 3/4 is filled by urine. Insert urinometer into it so that it floats in urine without touching the walls and bottom of containers. Free floating of urinometer must. It shouldn't touch the bottom or sidewall of containers. Read the graduations on the arm of urinometer at lower urinary meniscus. So here there is upper and lower urinary meniscus. You must read at lower urinary meniscus. Add or subtract 0.001 from the final readings for each 3 degrees centigrade above or below the calibration temperature respectively marked on the urinometer. So each urinometer has a specific temperature. That means it is calibrated for a specific temperature, right? For example, 25 centigrade. So if our room temperature or our laboratory temperature is higher or lower, subtractions or additions of factors must include for finer specific gravity readings. Other methods, refractometers, it measures the refractive index of urine. This procedure requires only a few drops of urine, in contrast to urinometers where approximately 100 ml of urine is required. So whenever there is very small amount of urine, that means less than 100 ml of urine, other methods like refractometer or reagent strip method is used for specific gravity measurements. Reagent strip methods, this implies the use of chemical reagent strips. Significance of specific gravity, normal specific gravity, diurnal variations ranging from 1.003 to 1.030. Low specific gravity causes are excess water intake or diabetes insipidus. High specific gravity due to dehydration, glycosuria, as in case of diabetes mellitus, or excessive proteinuria. Sometimes urinary specific gravity become fixed rather than normal diurnal variations. That is called fixed specific gravity of urine. Usually it is 1.010. Causes of fixed specific gravity of urine are ADH deficiency and chronic glomerulonephritis, anti-diuretic hormone deficiency and chronic glomerulonephritis. This one is common questions, viva questions. Causes of fixed specific gravity of urine and what is fixed specific gravity of urine. After physical examinations, coming to chemical examinations of urine. Test for proteinuria, that means detections of presence of proteins in urine. Prerequisitions for test for proteinuria, if urine is not clear, that means urine is turbid, it should be filtered or centrifuged before testing. Urine may be tested for proteinuria by qualitative as well as quantitative methods. Qualitative means whether there is presence or absence of proteins, and quantitative means exact amount of protein is measured within urine samples. Sometimes these methods may be semi-qualitative, or you can say semi-quantitative. Various qualitative tests for proteinuria like heat and acidic acid test, sulfur salicylic acid test, and reagent strip methods. Coming to heat and acidic acid test, principle is the protein are precipitated when boiled in acid solutions. So due to heating of proteins, it becomes denatured, and due to denaturation of protein, it get precipitated. This one is principle for heat and acidic acid test. Procedures: fill a test tube up to 2/3 with urine. Boil the upper portions by holding the tube up at the bottoms. Appearance of cloudiness or precipitate on the top may either be due to phosphates or it may be due to proteins. So to differentiate whether this cloudiness or precipitation is due to phosphates or proteins, we add 1 to 3 drops of 10% acidic acids and boil the top portions again. If the cloudiness due to phosphates, it gets disappears, but if cloudiness is due to proteins, it get persist or it get increased after additions of acidic acids. So this one is heat and acidic acid test. 2/3 test tube is filled with urine and upper portions is heated. Lower portions here act as a controls. Results depending on the cloudiness: negative means no cloudiness, trace means faint cloudiness, plus one cloudiness without granularity, plus two granular cloudiness, plus three precipitations and flocculations, and plus four means thick solid precipitates. So this one is also semi quantitative methods, because approximate quantity can be measured here, less than 0.1 grams, 0.1 grams, 0.12, 0.2 grams, etc. Second test for detection of protein is sulfur salicylic acid test. Principle: protein get denatured by organic acids and are precipitated. In heating acidic acids, protein get denatured by heating or boiling. Here, proteins get denatured by organic acid. Procedures: mix equal amount of clear urines with 3 to 5% sulfur salicylic acid in a test tube. Result or interpretations: cloudiness or heavy precipitations occurs if proteins are present. Here also there is gradings: negative, no cloudiness, no precipitations, mild precipitation stress, moderate precipitations or cloudiness, plus 1, then plus 2, plus 3 and plus 4. Reagent strip methods. Here for proteins, bromophenol coated strips is dipped in urines. Change in color of strip indicate presence of proteins in urine and is compared with the color charts provided for semi-quantitative gradings. So here this one is urine strips, two parameters, proteins and glucose. This one is for proteins. Depending on color change, you have compared these charts, and depending on color matchings, whether it is negative, trace, plus 1, 2, 3 or 4. So there are multiple parameters, 2 parameters, 3 parameters, up to 10 parameters or even 11 parameters are available nowadays on urine strips. Coming to quantitative estimations of protein in urine, two methods, one is Hbex albuminometer methods and other one is turbidimetric methods. Hbex albuminometer methods, this one is Hbex albuminometers. Fill the albuminometer with urine up to U marks. So here there are two marks, one is R, upper one is R, this one is U marks. So initially you should fill up to U marks. Urine is filled up to U marks. Add Hbex reagents. This contains prickly acid and citric acids up to R marks. This one is R marks. Stopper the tubes. Stopper. Mix it and let it stand for 24 hours. After 24 hours, take the reading from the lever of precipitates in the albuminometer tubes. So here there is gradings from 0 to up to 12, and you have to read amount of precipitations. Coming to poses of proteinuria, normally there is very scanty amount of protein in urine. There is, that means, less than 150 milligrams per 24 hours or per day. Heavy proteinuria, that means more than 3 grams per day. Causes for heavy proteinuria: nephrotic syndromes, renal vein thrombosis, diabetic mellitus and systemic lupus erythematosus. Moderate proteinuria, 1 to 3 grams per day. Causes are chronic glomerulonephritis, nephrosclerosis, multiple myeloma and pyelonephritis. Mild proteinuria, less than 1 grams per day. Causes are hypertension, polycystic kidney, chronic pyelonephritis, urinary tract infections and fever. After proteins, routine examinations of protein. Coming to facial examinations, like test for Benson's proteinuria. So these Benson's proteins are right chains of globulins. These are excreted in case of multiple myeloma and some other paraproteinemias like gammapathies. Characteristic of Benson's protein is, the protein is characterized by the formations of a precipitates when urine is heated at 40 to 60 degrees centigrade. It disappears wholly or partially as the temperature approaches the boiling point, that is 100 degree centigrade, and on cooling, precipitates reappears. Okay, microalbuminuria, that means very minute amount of albumin present in urine, that is called microalbuminuria. It is defined as the presence of albumin above the normal level but below the detectable range of conventional protein methods, that is ethyl acetic acid test, reagent strip test or sulfur salicylic acid test. And urine district methods, it ranges from 30 to 300 milligrams of albumin per 24 hours. So definitions of microalbuminuria is presence of albumin from 30 to 300 milligrams per 24 hours. Causes of microalbuminuria, diabetes and hypertension. After proteins, coming to chemical tests to detect sugar or glucose in urine. So test for glycosuria, that means presence of glucose in urine. Usually glucose will not be present in urine until blood glucose level exceeds 180 mg per deciliter. So this 180 mg per deciliter is called as renal threshold for glucose. If blood glucose level is greater than 180 mg, then it get appear in urine. Otherwise, it doesn't get appear in urine. Qualitative test for glycosuria, Benedict test and reagent strip test. Coming to Benedict test, principle of Benedict test. In strongly alkaline solutions and in the presence of heat, reducing substance reduces cupric ion to cuprous oxide. So, principle is reducing substance causes reductions of cupric ion into cuprous ion. And due to these reductions, there is color change of Benedict reagents. The reactions produce a color change of blue. Normally, Benedict reagent is of blue colors. If there is presence of reducing substance within the sample, this blue color get converted into green, yellow, orange or red depending upon the amount of reducing substance. If it is higher, then it is red. If it is less, then it is green. And in midway, it is yellow or orange. Procedure of Benedict test. Take 5 ml of Benedict reagents in a test tube. Add 8 drops or 0.5 ml of urine. So here Benedict reagent is 5 ml and urine is 0.5 ml. Heat to boiling for 2 minutes. Allow it to cool. And after cooling, result according to color changes. So interpretations negative, no color change. So if it remains blue, it is negative. If it becomes greenish color, that means there is trace sugars or trace amount of reducing substance less than 0.5 gram per deciliter. Green or cloudy green precipitations. Here just only colors. In class 1, there is presence of precipitates, green color precipitates. Plus 2, yellow precipitates. Plus 3, orange precipitates. Plus 4, red color or brick red color precipitates. Benedict reagents, blue colors, 5 ml Benedict reagents, 8 drops of urine, heating for 2 minutes. Here heating is done from bottom of tube rather than upper portion, as in case of ethyl acetic acid test. After cooling, observe the color changes. If blue, it is negative. Then green without precipitation, trace, green with precipitation, plus 1, yellow with precipitation, plus 2. Orange precipitate plus 3, red precipitate plus 4. False positive result in case of Benedict test, it may be due to other reducing sugars other than glucose, fructose, maltose and lactose, but not sucrose. So common viva questions here, which are reducing sugars other than glucose? Answer is fructose, maltose and dextrose. Then reducing substance, non-sugar reducing substance. So non-sugar reducing substance may be present in urine, include glucuronates, homozentic acid, ascorbic acids, some drugs also causes false positive reactions, penicillin, streptomycin, salicylates, urinary preservatives, formalin, heavy proteinuria may give false positive reactions, in heavy urate deposits also causes false positive result. Other methods, this reagent strip method, this one is specific for glucose. Benedict test is for reducing substance, but reagent strip is specific for glucose. These strips are coated with glucose oxidase and the test is based on enzymatic reactions. This one is specific for glucose. Coming to causes of glycosuria, commonest one is diabetes mellitus. Some endocrine disorders like Cushing's syndrome, hyperthyroidism, administrations of corticosteroids, renal glycosuria. If due to some congenital or other abnormality, if renal thresholds get reduced, then 180 mg per deciliter, then it is called renal glycosuria. Alimentary glycosuria sometimes occurs due to partial gastrectomy, that means removal of stomach or a portion of intestines. After meal, there is alimentary glycosuria. Severe burns, severe sepsis and pregnancy, there may be chances of glycosuria. Coming to test for ketone bodies. So, presence of ketone bodies in urine is called ketonuria. Here there is three types of ketone bodies may be present in urine: acetoacetic acids, acetone and beta-hydroxybutyric acids. So examples for name of ketone bodies: acetoacetic acid, acetone and beta-hydroxybutyric acid. Test for ketone ureas: Rothera test, Garrard test and reagent strip test. Coming to Rothera's test, principle of Rothera test, ketone bodies, acetone and acetoacetic acids. So here there is difference between Rothera and Garrard test. Rothera test detects both acetone and acetoacetic acids, while Garrard test detects only acetoacetic acid. Rothera test detects both acetone as well as acetoacetic acids, while Garrard test detects only acetoacetic acids. Principle of Rothera test, ketone bodies combines with alkaline solutions of sodium nitroprusside forming a pulpar complex. Procedure of Rothera test, take 5 ml of urine in a test tube, saturate it with ammonium sulfate salt. Add a few crystals of sodium nitroprusside and check the test tube. Add Ricker ammonia from the side of test tube. Interpretations of Rothera test: appearance of a pulpar or permanent colored ring at the junctions indicate presence of ketone bodies. This one is negative test: no purple colored ring at the junctions of Ricker ammonia and lower urine solutions. If there is permanent colored rings at the junctions of Ricker ammonia and urine solutions, it indicates presence of ketone bodies. Second method for ketone bodies is reagent strip test. These strips are coated with alkaline solutions of sodium nitroprusside. So same principles as of Rothera test, here also alkaline sodium nitroprusside coated reagent strip is used. When strip is dipped in urine, it turns pulpar if ketone bodies are present. Causes of glycosuria: commonest one is diabetic ketoacidosis due to severe amount of high blood sugar levels. So due to diabetes mellitus, there is diabetic ketoacidosis, starvation, severe dehydration, hyperemesis gravidum due to excessive vomiting, fever, cataxia and after general anesthesia. Coming to test for bile salts. Bile salts excreted in urine in case of obstructive and hepatocellular jaundice. Name of bile salts: cholic acid, deoxycholic acid, quinodeoxycholic acid and lithocholic acids. So these bile salts are present in case of obstructive and hepatocellular jaundice. Similarly, bile pigments are also present in case of obstructive jaundice and hepatocellular jaundice. Test for bile salts: egg sulfur powder test. Principle of this test: bile salts if present in urine lower the surface tensions of urine, and hence sulfur powder sinks to the bottom of tube. Principle is, due to presence of bile salts, there is reduction of surface tensions of urine, and due to reduction of surface tensions, this sulfur powder get sink to the bottom of test tube. Procedure of egg sulfur powder test: take 5 ml fresh urine in a test tube, or you can use beakers. So fill 2/3 of beakers with urine. Sprinkle sulfur powder on the surface of urine. Interpretations: in the presence of bile salts, sulfur powder sinks to the bottom of test tube or beaker. This one is urine samples, and here there is presence of sulfur powder at the bottom of test tube. That means bile salts are present in the sample. This one is control. Distilled water is used for controls. Here bile salts are floats at the top of the solution rather than present at the bottom. After bile salts, coming to test for bilirubin or bile pigments. Bilirubin is a breakdown product of hemoglobin, and normally there is no bilirubin in urine. So normally bilirubin is absent in urine. Various tests for detection of bile pigments in urine: Fawcett tests, also known as Harrison Potts tests, then foam test and reagent strip test. Fawcett test for bile pigments: principle, ferric chloride oxidize bilirubin to green bilirubin. Procedures: take 10 ml of urine in a test tube. Add 3 to 5 ml of 10% barium chloride. Filter through filter papers. To the precipitate on filter paper, add a few drops of Fawcett's reagents. This Fawcett's reagents contains ferric chloride plus trichloroacetic acid. Interpretations: development of green colors indicates presence of bile pigment or bilirubins. Filter paper, presence of precipitates. After adding Fawcett's reagents, if bile pigments are present, it gets converted into green colors. So blue-green precipitates are present on filter papers. Second method for bile pigment is reagent strip test. Here principle is different. In reagent strip test, it is based on coupling reactions of bilirubin with diazonium salt, with which strip is coated. Causes of bilirubinemia or presence of bile salts in urine: similar, obstructive jaundice and hepatocellular jaundice. Coming to test for urobilinogens. Two tests, one is Ehlich test and other one is reagent strip test. Normally, a small amount of urobilinogen is excreted in urine, 4 mg per 24 hours. So, urobilinogens is normally present in urine, while bile pigment or bilirubin is absent in urine. Flow charts: urine, urobilinogen in case of jaundice. If it increase, you have to done test for presence of bile pigments, that is urine bilirubins. If bile pigment is positive, it is due to hepatic jaundice. If it is negative, it is due to prehepatic or hemolytic jaundice. urine urobilinogens decrease or absent in urine, it suggests post-hepatic or obstructive jaundice. So here for bile salt, bile pigments and urobilinogens, bile salt and bile pigment are present in both hepatic and obstructive jaundice, while urobilinogen is absent in obstructive jaundice. Coming to test for blood in urine, benzidine test, orthotolidine test and reagent strip test. Causes of blood in urine: renal stones, renal tumors, polycystic kidney, bleeding disorders, trauma to GI tract, GUT, that means genitourinary tracts. After chemical examinations, coming to microscopic examinations of urine. Procedure for microscopic examinations of urine: take 5 to 10 ml of urine in a centrifuge tube. Centrifuge for 5 minutes at 3000 rpm. Discard the supernatant. Resuspend the deposit at the bottoms in a few drops of urine wrapped. Place a drop of this on a clean glass slide. Place a cover slip over it and examine it under microscope. So after centrifugations, supernatant is discarded. Whatever portions that is present in bottoms along with few drops of urine, they get resuspended. Place a drops on a clean glass slide and cover it with cover slips and examine under microscope. Initially, it should be examined under raw powder and to identify various cells, crystals, as well as parasites and other things, you have to go to higher power of microscope. Within microscopic examinations, it is divided into four categories: cells in urine, crystals in urine, cast in urine and miscellaneous things in urine. Coming to cells in urine, this includes red blood cells, WBC or leukocytes and epithelial cells. Red blood cells normally very rare amount, very few, 0 to 2 red blood cells per high power films may be present in urine. If red blood cells present in excess amount, there are various causes, physiological causes like following severe exercise, smoking and number lordosis. Pathological causes for presence of excess red blood cells in urine: renal stones, kidney tumors, glomerulonephritis, polycystic kidney, urinary tract infections and trauma. Coming to WBC or leukocytes, normally 0 to 4 WBC per high power fields. If it is greater than this normal range, there are various etiology like urinary tract infections, cystitis, prostatitis, chronic pyelonephritis, renal stones and renal tumors. So various infective causes along with stone and tumor. Here in case of stone and tumor, there is secondary infection. That's why there is increased amount of leukocytes in urine. Coming to epithelial cells, normally a few epithelial cells are seen. Especially these epithelial cells are in greater number in female patients than in male patients. However, if epithelial cells are large in number, there are various etiology, various infective conditions, inflammatory conditions or malignancy, there is increased epithelial cells in urine. After cells, coming to cast in urine, these casts are formed due to moldings in renal tubules of solidified proteins. So in renal tubules, there is moldings of protein occurs along with other constituents of urine. Various type of cast: hyaline cast. This hyaline cast is colorless, homogeneous and transparent. Colorless, homogeneous, transparent cast. This one is commonest cast found in urine, hyaline cast. Causes of hyaline cast: fever, exercise, acute glomerulonephritis, malignant hypertension and chronic renal disease. cellular cast, red cell cast. Its name itself suggests it contains red blood cells, and have a yellowish orange color because it contains red blood cells. That's why yellow to orange color. Causes of red blood cell cast: whenever there is hematuria, excessive presence of red blood cells along with some tubular abnormality, there is formation of red cell cast. So causes are acute glomerulonephritis, renal infarcts, Goodpasture syndromes, lupus nephritis. Yellowish orange color cast containing red blood cells. Leukocyte or WBC cast: this contains granular cells, WBCs, in a clear matrix. These all are WBC granular cells in a clear matrix. Causes of leukocyte cast: acute pyelonephritis. So here various infective conditions like acute pyelonephritis, glomerulonephritis, nephrotic syndromes, lupus nephritis, and interstitial nephritis. So whenever there is inflammation or infections, there is excessive WBC, they get converted into leukocyte cast. Coming to granular cast, here there is coarse granules in a basic matrix. So these granules forms from degenerations of cells or solidifications of plasma proteins. Causes of granular cast: pyelonephritis, chronic red poisoning, viral disease, and renal papillary necrosis. Coarse granules in a cast. Epithelial cast, cellular cast: here there is presence of epithelial cells within cast. So epithelial cast contains shed of tubular epithelial cells, larger in size than red blood cells and WBC, rounded in shape. These all are tubular epithelial cells, they form cast. Causes are acute tubular necrosis, heavy metal poisoning, renal transplant rejections. Waxy cast: yellowish, homogeneous, with irregular blunt or cleft ends, and have high refractive index. This waxy cast is also known as renal failure cast. So whenever there is renal failure, there is appearance of waxy cast. Yellow, homogeneous, with high refractive index. Causes of waxy cast: chronic renal failures, end-stage renal disease, renal transplant rejections. Fatty cast: name itself suggests it contains fat globules of varying size, which are highly refractile. Causes of fatty cast: nephrotic syndromes and fat necrosis. Then there are one special category of cast, it is called broad cast. Any kind of cast, whether it is cellular or granular or island cast, if it is 3 to 6 times broader than usual size, it is called broad cast. This may be epithelial, granular, or waxy cast. Causes of broad cast: end stage renal disease and uremia. After cells and cast, coming to crystals in urine. These crystals are divided into two categories: those present in acidic urine and those present in alkaline urine. Coming to crystals in acidic urines, examples are calcium oxalate crystals, commonest crystals, colorless, refractile, have octahedral envelope like structures. Also sometimes dumbbell shaped structures. So two kind of morphology: one is octahedral envelope shape and other one is dumbbell shape, refractile colorless crystals, that is calcium oxalate. Uric acid crystals, colored crystals, yellow or brown, rhomboid shapes, yellow to brown colors, seen either singly, here there is singly, or in rosette. This one is rosette formations by rhomboid yellow brown colored crystals. They can also be forms prisms, plates, or sieves. amorphous iodide crystals, yellowish brown colors. Amorphous means no particular morphology. So granular clumps, it forms clumps. Color of iodide crystal is yellowish brown. If made up of sodium iodate, they may have needle-like in the form of thorn apples. In this, especially seen in case of gout. Then tyrosine crystals, yellowish in colors, in the form of silky needles or sieves. It is seen in patients having jaundice. Tyrosine crystals, silky needles, or yellowish colors needles. Cystine crystals, colorless hexagonal plates, which are highly refractile. Colorless hexagonal plates. This is present in case of inborn error of metabolism called as cystinuria. That means presence of cystine in urine. Sometimes, very rarely, there is cholesterol crystals in urine, seen in case of urinary tract infections or rupture of lymphatic into renal pelvis or due to blockage of lymphatics. So this one is colorless cholesterol crystals, variable shapes but large in size. Then sulfonamides, due to sulfonamide ducts, yellowish sieves, rosettes, or rounded with radial striations, yellow colors but radial striations. After crystals in acidic urine, coming to crystals in alkaline urines, amorphous phosphates, colorless granules in the form of clumps or irregular aggregates. They dissolve when urine is made acidic. Then triple phosphate crystals in the form of prisms or open lids. So this is triple phosphate, open lid shapes or prism shapes. Sometimes there may be fun rib patterns. Calcium carbonate crystals in the form of granules, fairs, or rarely dumbbell shapes. So this one is calcium carbonate granules, dumbbell shapes, or spheres. Then ammonium biurate, round or oval, yellowish brown spheres with thorns on their surface, giving thorn apple appearance. Thorn apple appearance. After cells, cast and crystals, coming to miscellaneous structures in urine. So here also common viva patients, parasites, tet can, or that may be present in urine specimens like Trichomonas vaginalis, Microfilaria, Kystosoma hematobiums, and E. vermicularis. Sometimes fungal may be detected, especially Candida or yeast. Spermatozoa, especially in male patients, and if there is malignancy involving genitourinary tracts, there may be presence of malignant cells, that is tumor cells. Thank you.